Johnny was a brilliant student. He flew through primary school, he flew through secondary school, and he went off up to UCD. And after about a month anyway, the Pillar of Irish Society, Mammy, decided that she was going to go up to see him. So he went out to the station house to meet her, brought her back around the flat, showed her around the flat, everything going grand. And after a few minutes, he introduced her to his new flatmate, Vicky. Now, Johnny's mother was typical of an awful lot of Irish mothers. She could actually sit there and, without ever opening her mouth, ask a question. She had one look at Vicky. She wasn't opening her mouth, but she was asking a lot of questions. And after a while, the penny dropped with Johnny, so he decided he might as well make some kind of an attempt to answer the question that his mother never asked. "It's not like what you thinks at all now, mother," he said. "Vicky is my flatmate, and we have separate rooms." She was happy enough anyway, and she went off down the country, and after about a week later, the postboy arrived at her door with a letter from John, thanking her for coming up, really appreciated her company. Vicky appreciated her company, and they were really delighted to see her. But you know now something, mother, since you left, Vicky has a problem. Vicky is missing her sugar bowl. Now, I'm not saying, mother, that you took the sugar bowl. I'm not saying, mother, that you did not take the sugar bowl. But the fact remains, mother, that since you left, Vicky is missing her sugar bowl. Mother got the letter anyways, and she opened and she said, "Yes," she said, "I better reply to this." So she wrote back up to John anyway, thanking him for the great time they had, really appreciated all they'd done for her, and delighted for everything they'd done. Now she said, "John, to get to the core of your letter. I'm not saying, John, that you're sharing your bed with Vicky. I'm not saying, John, that you're not sharing your bed with Vicky. But the fact remains, John, that if Vicky was sleeping in her own bed, she'd have found the sugar bowl."